Every human being, they have a uniqueness about them that you can grasp with a photograph. Photography saved my life. It was exactly what I needed to do and what I was born to do. I grew up on the northwest side of Detroit. Photography has been a way of being my therapy. One of the things that I want to talk about specifically is how mindful photography is and how it requires for you to take your thoughts and focus on something else. And it was a time where my mother, she had gotten ill, she had a stroke, and I was, you know, in extreme panic, and you know, I needed to take a walk. And I was just walking around, and you know, I saw the way this light was hitting the building and the textures on the building, and I was like, oh my God, it's so beautiful. And I had to take out my camera and started just taking pictures. And it literally took me out of that element and had me focus on something else. The meaning for the textures is just the history behind it. You know, how did those textures come about? What did those places look like beforehand? And a lot of the portraiture and stuff that I shoot is, it's a documentary of history. It is like a way of just remembering a time. And so those textures are bits and pieces of a time that has passed. I love to take posed, candid photos. There's always those instances of a glimpse of a person. And a lot of times when I start to shoot, I'm looking for that in-between, just so that I can capture the real essence of a person. There's a photo called West Side. I literally pulled up on these people. It was a father and a son standing outside, and it was the golden hour in photography. The sun was shining, and it just looked beautiful. I took a picture of them in the midst of asking them, can I take a photo? And I continued to photograph them a little bit more, but it was that first shot that got it. For a long time, I photographed a lot of nude women, black women specifically. And it was because there really wasn't enough black women being shown in a way that was artistic. And I wanted to present them as beautiful in their body. And that was a learning process for me because I had to become comfortable with myself. The series of mixed media photographs that I did with merging the textures and the portraiture together was really embracing our history, our lineage, how we go through life from beginning to end. You know, those textures, all of that information in there, in our being and how we interact with each other. So there is a photo of a man and a woman. They're like my grandparents. Starting there at that unit was pretty much the head of the family. We look to them for our wisdom. And then I have another exact photo of a younger generation, of a young boy and a young girl, because that's our beginning, that's where our start is. There's this one picture, it's just a bunch of kids on the playground. And I was like, hey y'all, come together, get together, let me get a photo of you. And the pose that they gave me was so fierce. That's one of my favorite pictures. You wanna be able to educate people with your work. That doesn't always have to be in the form of, you know, a protest. It can be in the form of just healing the people as is. That's what I do. I use it as a way to heal myself and whomever else that comes in contact with it. I love to give back because I had some amazing mentors. I've taught, you know, middle and high school students photography. I started a business called Photo Sensei, which is photography tours and workshops around the Detroit area. Another thing that I've done is open up the Norwest Gallery of Art. Norwest Gallery is in North Rosedale Park on Grand River between Evergreen and Otter Drive. Norwest comes from the Norwest Theater that used to be on Grand River, just on the other side of Southfield Freeway. This is an opportunity for me to create a platform for artists who are emerging, all the way up until strong professional artists that's been doing it for years. it was really a matter of wanting to create a platform and space for people to exhibit and show their work, express themselves in a way that's a safe space to just be yourself.
I love curating shows.
I like to get people to feel. So it's a big part of my art. You know, I come up with a concept or an idea and just push it to the limit. I select the artists that I think would be able to convey that message in their medium, and it's super exciting to me. The gallery has definitely taken on its own life, you know, and it is a necessary place for this neighborhood. I show Detroit how Detroit performs by just being myself. I'm always gonna be Asia in my work, in how I greet people, how I run my space. It's all very calm. When people come in here, they're smiling and they're like, oh my God, the energy in here is so good. And that's because I want you to know that I'm sharing a part of my love with you. You know, this is my passion, this is my home. So it's like me opening up my home to you.